Scud Brothers Fishing Adventures, sponsored in part by Rainbow Taxidermy for all your taxidermy needs. And by Spoons Cafe, home of gourmet sandwiches, desserts, and coffee. We've got a brook trout adventure for you. The boys and I go back to one of our favorite weekend retreats, Raven Lake. Teeming with a large selection of stocked eastern brook trout and native large rainbows, this lake never ceases to give up great fishing action, whether on shore or in a boat. It's early October, and unlike rainbows, brook trout spawn later in the season. Bait casting and fly fishing will be the complement this trip. So get settled in, folks, as we experience fall in the Chilcotin. After that, Daryl can't wait to get out of the rain and embark on his first northern pike adventure. The Moberly River is the setting as we cast some of the banks and underwater log structures hunting for the all-time predator himself. Using spoons and large spinners, we'll hook up with some of these babies and catch a little bit of what Daryl was inflicted with, pike fever.
Ah, BC's Chilcotin, the high country. Untamed wilderness you'd expect for being an adventurous. Here, the air is fresh, the stars are close, and wildlife frequently appear. With generous portions of live bait and a few colorful flies to present, we leisurely sample fishing this lake on top of the world had to offer.
Big one. Gee whiz, look at the size of that trout, man.
All right.
Whoa! Holy smokes. Look at this fish. He's big.
Right off the dock.
Yeah. Nice big. Oh, look at the size of that brook trout, man.
You can call it a dock, eh?
Look at the size of that trout.
Oh, that's big.
Oh, man, that's the biggest one I got on my wall. Look at that, eh? Hey folks, we stopped here at Raven Lake. Look at the size of that brook trout.
Ha ha! And like always, the dock gets the first fish.
And they're all sitting right in here, eh? And they're all pretty big. Oh, look at that right away. Got him! Woo! Another nice one. Look at that, eh? Whoa! Hey, come on over here, you can cast closer. To where they are. Oh, it's a nice big male again, eh? Holy smokes. Oh. Boy, it's a big trout. Another big one. I don't get it. Oh, yeah. Beautiful fat brookies.
Here's a nice big male right there. Bring the worms, bud. Here's a good look at him, a nice fat male. I put one of these on my wall last winter time because they look so pretty. We'll let him go.
It's a hit, I got a hit.
Oh, come on, another one?
Yeah.
I'm taking that spot, I tell ya. This is incredible.
You know, we fish Raven Lake. It's a very common lake for us to come to. You could actually classify it as one of the Scud Brothers' stomping grounds.
Oh, that's, I love this lake.
We nice fish here. We sit here for days and not caught anything but the scenery. And where we are, just a beautiful place to be. It's excellent camping. There's lots of facilities here. There's good picnic tables. There's lots of firewood always cut. Raven Lake, folks, bring your kids.
Hey, let me in.
It's a great place. I can't give you the spot now.
Oh, get out of the way.
Come on. I got a hit here.
Yeah.
nice one. Nice brookie. Don't lose him, huh? Reel and pull, reel and pull. Boy, he's a big fish, man. Can't believe it. Yeah. Nice one.
Geez, I want to get back out there. Another nice little brook trout from Raven Lake. Well, this one's going in the frying pan, and I'm getting back out there to catch a few I can let go.
These fish are sizable. It's unbelievable. They're a nice fish. Big brook trout. And you know, folks, we just happened to pop here just on a fluke. And the brook trout fishing is fantastic. This is a big fish too, Daryl. Yep. Yeah, flat tire. Get out of those weeds. Come on. Out of those weeds. Another nice big male. Ooh, man, look at the size of these trout. Wow, look at the color of that fish. That's got to be just some of the gorgeous colors I've ever seen in a brook trout. Hey, and that's Raven Lake, folks. You can bring your kids. And the fishing is fantastic. Look at that, eh? Wow, isn't that beautiful? Just gorgeous. Look at that, eh? What time there, bud? Nice trout. Size, eh? Well, nice brook trout, buddy.
Thank you.
Get him on the platform here, I guess, eh?
Yeah. Bobbing and doer. Oh, yeah, nice.
Beautiful, beautiful.
Bigger than the last one, eh?
Yeah.
Beauty.
He is. Yeah,
she's beauty. Going back.
Okay, put him back there, bud. Real nice. Hey, this is a good brook trout fishing this time of year, getting close to wintertime. And the brook trout, whoop, going the wrong way. There he goes. Come on. Whoa, he's out of there. I got a bullet. Jeez, get over here. Okay. Get in there. All right.
Oh, right in the side. Nice.
Yeah, just nice. He attacked it there. Okay. Now, there is another male, a buck, not quite in the traditional colors yet, though. Yeah, flies just barely in there. There it is. Yeah, nice little buck. Beautiful red, eh? Boy, it's amazing.
Ready.
Great action.
Like a bullet.
Just get me wet. Oh, man. Oh, hey, buddy, it's your turn to catch a fish.
Yeah, okay. Tell the
okay.
fish that.
Tell who?
Tell the fish that.
That's right. Okay, I'm just going to put back out there, and we're going to see if we can get that to happen again. That was just right there. It didn't take long. Let's just see what happens again here. Oh, that guy was charging. Another real nice classic Raven Lake brook trout, and they're still pretty sizable too. Right? Getting late in the season here. Okay. Yeah. Just using a grub here today. I'm trying a few little different things. Okay. Well, he's not quite as big as the last one. I guess maybe he is. Oh, yeah, he's a little bit bigger. There he is. Almost same fish, eh? All right. Get that hook out of there. And there he is. A nice little brook trout. Another one. Ooh.
Okay.
And he's off.
Well, I got a bit of a problem with the fly rod. The line's all kinked up.
I guess I'm going to fix that. Let's have a message from Ducks Unlimited. We'll be right back.
Got off.
Don't shake it off by me, boy. You.
Oh, there's that log, eh? Oh, he's running good. There we are. Now we got a handle on him. Yep. Now we got a handle on him. That didn't take long. Just put the fly in the water, eh? Another nice size, too, eh? Just unreal. Okay. All right. Well, this has got to be one of those fishing shows where you want to show fish that are so colorful. Because, let's face it, that's what a fishing show is all about. Getting to see some of the fish and some of the exuberant colors that they can display. Oops. Okay. Oh, this guy's just too much. All right. All right. He wants some more time. We can't give it to him. There it is. Okay. Take that hook out. Slowly, small hooks. Another nice brook trout. Just gorgeous. You know, folks, only 1 hour from Williams Lake, British Columbia, you can experience some of the best brook trout fishing this side of Alberta, no doubt. There's a lot of good brookies in this province. Raven Lake is one of the places to come to. But you got to realize, keeping a lot of these fish is going to destroy a lake like this, and it is does have a lot of pressure all year long. It has thousands of anglers here, ice fish, and ice fishing as well. We did a show here. Ice fishing is just fantastic here. And this has got to be some of the best fishing I've seen this time of the year for brook trout. It definitely works. Raven Lake, folks.
And I think I got everything. Tackle box, cooler, stove, motor, gas, net, and fishing rod. Can't go without that. Hey folks, today Glenn and I are heading back up to Region 7. We're going after some tackle busted pike and whatever else we happen to run into along the way, whitefish, grayling, walleye. Boy, I tell you, it's gonna be nice to get out of this rain. I can't wait. Well, Glenn's down at the studio finishing up the last film, so I'm gonna head down there and get him. Man, I can hardly wait to get into some of those pike.
Everybody, don't forget to catch the Scud Brothers Fishing Adventures next week. We're going to get a little serious about gang trolling and talk about some of those little known techniques. Once again, we're going to show off the old Scud Brothers trill and compare its success to the standard gang troll bait, the Dewworm. So join us for an informative half an hour as I tackle some of the caribou's finest next week.
All right, another pike. Down the way he goes. Whew. You know, it's so nice to fish some of these pike because we've been fishing rainbows and char for so long, eh, Daryl? And the pike are much more resilient than a lot of the trout.
They're damn aggressive.
Oh boy, they sure are. Okay, Well, we're getting lucky. We're just the boat. We're sitting in the river, anchoring on some certain spots, looking for some structural elements. We're fishing around dead snags in deeper pools, and the fish, the pike, of course, are like a predator fish, and they sit right in secluded areas, and they wait for those lures to pass, and they smack them. So let's get back out there. When they start staying down, you know they're pretty big.
But you're out of pie, man.
Oh boy. How big is he? Not bad. There he is.
Whoa!
Tackle busting fish. On the motor. Watch your motor. Oh, you weren't watching. Yeah, cut your line. Don't force him.
I got the fish in that.
No, I don't.
Yeah, now I do.
Whoa!
Yeah, you gotta keep your beware of that, man. Ooh, that thing's heavy.
Yeah.
Jeez. Oh, broke the line there. Almost.
He was playing me for a sucker, guy,
right?
That's right. Trying to make me think he was a little 2-pound fish.
Yeah. And we're going against all laws today, folks, because we're not using leaders. But so far, what's going to happen is we're going to put one of our best lures on. It'll break, and they'll say, well, we should have had a leader. Well, this morning we're using some spinners, just basically light tackle. I haven't got fly rod out yet, but that may come in handy later on. We're using some spoons, crocodile type lures, panther martin, of course, always.
Okay, see him there? There's not a bad looking pike.
Turn him to the left more.
He's got to be a good 4 pounds.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Nice looking, man.
Here.
Oh, it's a big one. I think it's a pike. Don't know, he's running. Come on, buddy. Oh, God, he's heavy.
He's a pike, isn't
it? Yep, here he comes. Yeah, I was looking for some of the structural elements hanging off the side of the river here. Like, for example, trees, some shady spots there, Daryl.
Yeah, well, that's a perfect spot right in there.
Yeah, that's tree, what I figured, eh? Some grassy bank. I figured it'd be a pike right in there. I don't even know what it is yet, but...
Some grassy what, area.
Whatever it is, it's coming up. Boy, he's just turning the boat right around. He's
Holy
heavy, this
cow,
fish.
Is he ever, eh? Right into
the sun. Not gonna come up. Oh, big pike, I think.
Oh, under the boat.
Oh, no, the anchor, get out of there. Oh, is it a pike? Must be. Pretty long, eh? Oh, yeah,
I can't
nice
see
pike.
Him yet.
Oh, good pike. Oh, boy, it's heavy. Come on, buddy. Here he comes. Oh, the size of that pike, man. Whew, look at that bruiser. Oh.
Come on, he gets close to the boat, boy, he runs.
Come on, buddy. Oh, it's a nice pike. Oh, on the other side, eh? Oh, there he is. Look at that.
Oh, that's a big one.
Hurry up, buddy. Here he comes. Oh. Come on, on the side. Here he comes. Here he comes. Oh, holy cow. Gee, with no leader, too, eh?
Yeah.
Oh, no. Okay, here he comes. Oh, here he comes. Oh,
whoa,
look
a
at
nice
the size of that. Keep it down. Keep it down.
Boy. What a beauty.
What
a Panther Martin.
Panther Martin, eh, bud?
Hey.
Well, it just shows you the old trout lures, they work everywhere we seem to go. That's a nice northern,
that's
man.
That's a beauty.
Or they call them jackfish in this area, as we found out, eh?
Yeah.
Oh, that's not a pike, that's a jackfish.
Yeah, call it by its proper name, he said.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Whoa. Holy smokes. That's got to go for sure, but 8-10 pounds, eh?
Oh, man.
It's a big fish.
He's heavy.
Yeah.
He's heavy.
Okay.
A little bit higher.
And we'll let her go. Okay, get that picture there, Daryl. Now try that one.
Well, I'll do a little slightly different pose here.
Yeah. It's a little bit dirty.
Look at him and smile. Beauty.
Okay. Okay, Brad, this is where you zoom in for the still. And we're gonna let him go. There she goes. Whoa, boy. Whew. Well. You know, I didn't even put a leader on my line there, thinking that, well, we probably won't see too many pike, and whack, right into them.
Yeah,
boy, I got lucky. I guess I'm going to check my line.
That was great.
Oh, sure was. Well,
hey,
okay.
Get back up that spot. Maybe his brother's up there.
You got it. Let's go back up. Well, this is totally new for Daryl. He's a BC native, and I'm from Ontario myself originally, And I'll tell you, this trip has meant a lot to me because as a kid, bass and pike, well, what's it feel like? Not bad. Bass and pike were things we grew up on. So being here, for me, it's totally exciting, and I know what to expect, but Daryl's never even seen
a pike fishing trip. It's my first pike fishing trip.
Yeah. And no real trophies yet today, but we've seen a couple nice ones.
Oh, that's
some for that, good quality
that,
fishing.
That one you caught earlier, that was a nice big fish.
Yeah, he was nice, but he good
was,
quality
he
fishing.
He was a good 2 pounds heavier. Oh, I'd say a good 3-4 pounds heavier than that one.
Yeah.
Well,
off the back of the boat here because
right off the back of the boat.
Yeah. I'm getting mad. I'm picking all the great spots and he's throwing off the back of the boat.
Well, that's where they're biting.
Yeah.
I'll pick one of your spots over there now.
Yeah, okay. Right in a tree.
Yeah. I've been pretty lucky getting them out of the trees.
No kidding, eh? Oh yeah, a little pike. Whoa! Okay.
Hey,
spoon bait off, bud.
Yep.
Here you are.
Right?
Yeah, one's got lots of scars. Look at that. It's been hit by a few other pike, eh?
He's been beat up.
Here you go, man. Nice fish. Okay.
Hang on.
Let's get my pliers. Just undo him. We're going to float to shore. That's okay. Wash your fingers. You really got to watch these teeth in these pike, man, because they are just unreal. Okay, let me just get that spoon. Okay, I'll get the fish out. A little bit lure later.
Leave the fish there for now. Get the hook out of here first.
Look at the scarring on his back, Daryl. It looks like he's been nipped by another few other pike.
Yeah. He's a little
pike are very common for charging at each other and just territorial like crazy.
Cannibalistic almost, cannibalistic. They eat each other.
Yeah, they eat everything. Okay, well,
settle down there now.
Let him go.
Oh yeah, I think we'll just let him right out of the net.
All right. All right. There he goes.
There he goes. There he goes.
All right.
Nice easy.
Wow, folks. You know, we really did catch a lot of pike that trip. And for Daryl's first time, he did great. It just didn't seem to matter what lure he used. Man, he was hitting them. And of course, it's thanks to North Shore Off-Road that enabled us to get lost for 4 hours in the bush. You know, we never did find that secret pike hole. Well, one thing we didn't do was predict that darn weather. Here, we moved north to Fort St. John and Charlie Lake. Well, for the most part, the lake was unproductive, but we did pick up a few small walleyes. You know, the action wasn't too bad, but the wind and the rain eventually took its toll on us. We tried a lot of different lures on the lake that day, but the Rapala shad wrap seemed to be our answer as we fished off the bottom. Daryl holds up the spiny dorsal fin of the walleye. A pretty prickly reminder, eh, bud? Well, that's our cue. What a storm. Hit the road. On the way back to the Chetwynd area, Hudson Hope caught our interest, even in the rain. There she stood, tall, long, and almost unbelievable, the Bennett Dam. Being the weather was bad, we thought we'd take in a little bit of the sights inside. But you could easily spend hours here. Daryl tracing the path of a 1,000-year-old trachodon. But inside, there's a lot of hands-on displays, so to speak. And hey, folks, putting your hands on some of the stuff is no fun at all. This particular part of the dam has a miniature laid-out model just to the inside. It's really surprising how close they really are. Here he goes, getting brave again. Like, what's up, Daryl? What's up? Gee, bud, if you only had that kind of magnetism when it comes to catching some of those big ones. Well, finally back to town. That figures. The sun's out. just enough time to catch our only whitefish before hitting the road.
Into the Scud Brothers Fishing Diary. I sure hope you enjoyed the show this week, because we sure enjoyed bringing you some different fish for a change. You know, this was my first pike experience, and I tell you, it was everything Glen said it would be. We didn't get any trophies, but hey, the fishing was pretty darn good. Well, you know, fishermen, in closing, let's do our part to keep the environment clean and preserve our playground. And we'll see you again next week for another adventure. I'm Daryl Cody.
Okay. Whoa! Holy! No catch today.
Okay.
A hatfish.
Yeah. Holy!
Is that a hat trick or what?
It's cold enough.
Well, let's hope it doesn't snow until we get that tire changed.
If anybody out there is on a cellular, call BCAA for us, please. We're
there
Raven
you go.
Lake.
Raven Lake, yeah.